Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. Hard Knocks Episode 2 is in the book. So I'm going to be breaking down a bunch of different things on today's show. First thing that I want to get into, it's the five things that I learned from Episode 2 of Hard Knocks. So here's how this one's going to go, okay? Coming up on the Raiders Report, the five things that we learned from Hard Knocks Episode 2. The AB helmet saga, was it just a Hard Knocks ploy? We'll get into that one a little bit later, and then I'm going to break down grades from Hard Knocks episode 1 and 2, and we're ultimately going to compare which episode was better, the debut or was episode 2 of Hard Knocks better. Make sure you guys are interacting with the most watched YouTube live channel here for all Raiders content. Make sure you subscribe at the Oakland Raiders Report on YouTube. So the five things that we learned here on Hard Knocks episode 2, a lot of it is around Antonio Brown, and a lot of it is around AB's disgusting feet. The number one thing that I learned, Antonio Brown showed his feet on the show. You saw like right when it first happened, and then for those of you that have never seen Antonio Brown's feet, guess what? I got you. So here you go. Check out these bad boys. They're gross, man, right? They're not pretty whatsoever. But here's the other thing. They also go into a little bit more depth about exactly what happened. Antonio Brown talked about going into the machine. Antonio Brown talked about when he came out, he's like, man, my feet are on fire. They feel like they're burning. And then he had to, you know, get them looked at. And you can also see the entire off-field drama with all the players, and they want to know what is happening with Antonio Brown's disgusting feet. Now, there is a report out that's already that Brown doesn't expect to play versus the Cardinals Thursday, August 15th, in their second preseason game, which doesn't surprise me. But Mike Mayock said it, Jon Gruden said it, that they expect Antonio Brown week one to play against the Denver Broncos. And between you and me, would you rather have AB play Thursday against the Cardinals in week season preseason game? Or would you rather have Antonio Brown playing week one versus Denver Broncos? I think we can all agree it's against the Denver Broncos. So the first thing that I learned is AB's feet, they're disgusting, right? Now, I also want to ask a question, and you know, you guys can just throw it in here. Are you guys sick of the Antonio Brown drama? You know, why for yes and for no? Because between you and me, I'm sick of the AB drama. I just want to see 84 lacing up his cleats and getting on the field. So, for everyone who's watching us live on YouTube and watching us live on Facebook, are you sick of the Antonio Brown drama? Why for yes and for no? Between you and me, I'm calling God. All right, let's go to the second thing that I learned today from episode 2 of Hard Knocks. Keelan Doss, he's on the roster bubble. So the show kind of starts off a little bit with Antonio Brown's feet, and then we get into Keelan Doss and how, you know, he's working, how he's an undrafted free agent. But Jon Gruden is excited about Keelan Doss, and he looked pretty good in practice. And they also then go into some drops that Keelan Doss had. He has shown where he can excel, and then he also shows, you know, where he's got some drop issues. Now, in 2018, 2017 in college, the dude was putting up disgusting numbers, like absolutely great numbers, okay? But here's the thing. He might not make that final roster because the Raiders do have 12 wide receivers on the team. And when you add players like Antonio Brown, Tyrell Williams, you draft Hunter Renfrow, plus J.J. Nelson played well, Keon Hatcher played well, Ryan Grant played well, you know that they're going to keep Dwayne Harris for special teams. Where exactly is he going to fit in on this team? So here's the official Raiders wide receiver depth chart as of this week, okay? As you can see, Keelan Doss isn't on this list, but if he continues to play well, maybe, just maybe, he won't be on that roster bubble. And also, it was fun to see him, that Jon Gruden was kind of joking around with him because he's from Cali. You know, he's literally from the Oakland area. So they were joking around. They were like, hey, man, how many people you got coming to the game? Keelan's like, I don't know, maybe two. I got a bunch of people. Like, it was pretty good. I like the fact that they featured Keelan Doss, undrafted free agent. And for those of you that are going to be waiting for my winners and losers, stay tuned. You might see this guy a little bit later on. So, or at least definitely one of the rookie wide receivers. So Keelan Doss is a fun player. So I want to ask you guys this question. Will Keelan Doss make the final roster? Okay, that final 53 man, will Keelan Doss make it? I want you to literally type yes, or I want you to type no. For those of you that are going to type yes, Tell me which wide receiver isn't going to make the team. For those of you that are typing no, tell me why you don't see Keelan Doss making the final roster. So here, we're going to have some fun here. I've been telling you guys to subscribe to the Raiders Report. So click that big red button. And for those of you that are colorblind, because actually I had somebody DM me and said, Mitch, I'm colorblind. Click that big gray button that says subscribe, youtube.com/Raidersport. I'm trying to get to 21,000 by Thursday, okay? Right now at 20,328 when I made this video. I'm trying to get to 21K by Thursday because we're going to do a watch party. So tell your friends, bring a cold one. We're going to sit down, watch the Raiders beat up on the Cardinals. So make sure you guys are there. Click that big red button or gray. Subscribe to the number one most watched Raiders channel on YouTube and actually on Facebook as well. All right, the third thing that I learned from Hard Knocks Episode 2 featuring the Oakland Raiders, the Raiders need to protect Derek Carr. I about had a freaking heart attack. There was like this one play. They're kind of leading up into it. They're like, you can see that the quarterbacks, they're all wearing red. And the reason why they're wearing red is so that you don't hit the quarterback. And then all of a sudden, you see a defensive end dive at Derek Carr's knees, a lot like when you see a quarterback go down with an ACL injury. It looked scary. And Derek kind of limped off the field a little bit. He made a joke like, man, the guy almost took off my leg. And Jon Gruden, as he should have been, was pissed off. Like, you're literally wearing a red jersey. If there is one player who you cannot hit, it needs to be Derek Carr. And the fact that he almost got hit in the knees, and it looked bad. I'm telling you right now, it looked pretty bad. This entire offseason has been around protecting Derek Carr. You go out and get Trent Brown. The offensive line has been upgraded. You add Antonio Brown, Tyrell Williams, and the reason why you need to protect Carr, because you need to figure out whether or not that you can bring him back in 2020. So this is what Derek Carr is going to be making in 2019. A lot of money. You can't cut him. But in 2020, a $5 million cap hit. A 2021, $2.5 million dead cap hit if the Raiders wanted to move on from Carr. This year is a figuring out if Derek Carr is your man. And if he would have been lost for the entire season because somebody took a dive at his knees at practice, I would have went absolutely AWOL. Now, between you and me, I think Derek is a solid quarterback. 122 touchdowns his entire career. Over 18,000 yards. Heck, he needs 29 touchdowns to set the career most for passing touchdowns by a Raiders quarterback. He only needs 324 yards to set the career mark for most passing yards by a quarterback in Raiders history. Derek is a very good quarterback. But like most quarterbacks, they feed off energy. They feed off confidence. And if you're not confident that your offensive line is going to protect you, you're not going to be as successful. Go back and look at his great years in 2015, 2016. Derek didn't get sacked. Last year, he got sacked 52 times, the fifth most in the NFL. Now, between you and me, I think one of the reasons, FC. Let me see some FCs in the comments section. Fire Tom Cable. Now, I'm going to try not to talk too much about Cable, but I'm interested. I still have yet to see a Tom Cable sighting, and Hard Knocks is probably smart because, you know, they don't really want to see Tom Cable on HBO Hard Knocks. So I said this before, Derek Carr was sacked 52 times. So how many times will Derek get sacked this season? The number that I'm at right now, fingers crossed, is about 30 to 32. I think this Raiders offensive line is solid. Sure, losing Gabe Jackson to 6 to 8 weeks. Sure, not having Richie Incognito's first 2 weeks doesn't help. But you go out, you get Trent Brown. Colt Miller's going to be better in year two. You have the best pass-blocking center in the league in Rodney Hudson. How many times will Derek Carr get sacked? I'm going to be looking in the comments section, so you better see. You better be ready for me to come at you if you're throwing out some just absolutely outlandish numbers. Now, I actually have an outlandish deal for everyone right now, thanks to our sports sponsor, MyBookie. Go to chatsports.com/Raiders and use my promo code GoRaiders for 100% deposit bonus. And if you're like, Mitch, what does that mean? It means if you put down $100, you're going to get $100 for free. Go bet on Josh Jacobs winning Rookie of the Year. Was Josh Jacobs even on Hard Knocks Episode 2? No. Was he on Episode 1? No. Maybe you shouldn't do it. I'm just saying. Will the Raiders make the playoffs? You can bet on all these things at MyBookie. If you're a confident fan If you're an actual fan of the Raiders, and if you're an actual fan of what I do here on the Raiders Report, you will go to chatsports.com/Raiders, and you will use my promo code GORAIDERS. And how about this? For any single person that actually does this, send me a screenshot of you signing up with my bookie, putting down $50, and I'm going to hook you up with some Raider Nation swag. That sound good? Okay, let's keep the show rolling here. The fourth thing that I learned on Hard Knocks tonight is that the Raiders really struggled versus the Rams in that day one practice. It was bad. They got whooped. Like, from what it looked like and from everything that I heard, the Raiders got absolutely manhandled against the Rams day one. Derek didn't look good. The defense didn't look good. The offensive line didn't get... They got worked. They got worked in the trenches. Now, sure, the Rams were 13-3 last year. They lost in the Super Bowl. They are a very good team. And I expect them to be good this year. Jared Goff is a good quarterback. Aaron Donald is the best player in the NFL. Todd Gurley, solid running back. And if you really want to prove that you are an actually legitimate team, you need to go up against teams like the Rams in training camp. Also, a fun little note, it was cool to see Jon Gruden and Sean McVay get together again. For those of you that don't know, Sean McVay worked underneath Jon Gruden with the Buccaneers. I'm sitting here making the show with Tad, producer Tad, and we're like, oh my God, look at Sean McVay and Jon Gruden. Like, Sean McVay looked like a 23-year-old kid. Which, actually, he probably was about 23, back when Jon Gruden was coaching with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. But here's the thing. From start to finish in that day one practice, it didn't look good. And I don't want to see that. And the other thing that I saw that really stuck out to me, Derek Carr throws a beautiful ball to Tyrell Williams. Would have been an easy touchdown. And it went right between his hands. That's not the kind of shit that I want to see from my wide receiver who, yes, can stretch the field, can go deep, can go get that ball. But if you can't bring it in, that's really going to tick me off. So the thing that I learned, number four, was Raiders. They really struggled versus the Rams on day one. But here's the thing, okay? Day one might have been bad. Now, we drafted a lot of these rookies to really make that big impact. So the next thing that I learned on Hard Knocks was the rookies, they played really, really well on day two. And Jon Gruden and Mike Mayock, they were fired up that their rookies came up and played. Cleveland Furl, a lot of talk about him during the show. Cleveland Furl brought his A game. Cleveland Furl, you could tell, wanted to get after the quarterback. Also, Jonathan Abram, another star of the show, Jonathan Abram. He was so excited to be able to hit somebody not wearing silver and black. It was actually kind of comical, and I love me some Jonathan Abram. The dude is physical, and the fact that these rookies are as fiery as what they are, I'm excited. Plus, we got to saw some fights. Like, if you're telling me I get to watch Hard Knocks and I don't get to see a fight, that's like me watching a hockey game and saying there's not going to be a fight. If you could tell me ahead of time that there's not going to be a fight in a hockey game, I'm not going to watch the game. Plain and simple. Won't do it. If you're telling me I'm going to watch a NASCAR race and somebody's not going to get into a fight in a NASCAR race, I'm probably not going to watch that one either, because between you and me, they're just turning left and I don't really know if it's a sport or not. So I was excited to see that the rookies played well on day two, and the fact that I just said NASCAR wasn't a sport, I think I just gave Tad a heart attack. Also, what might give you a heart attack are Cleveland Furl's numbers, what he did at Clemson. 51 tackles, 18.5 tackles for a loss, 11.5 sacks. It's a reason why he got the best defensive player in college football. It's a reason why the Raiders went out and drafted Cleveland Furl, number four overall in the 2019 NFL draft. And the other thing that I learned a lot about Jon Gruden during the draft was he likes Clemson players, which I don't blame him. You're going to get players who know how to live in the big time. You're going to find players who can buy into a system, who play really hard. Cleveland Furl is a part of that system, and it's a reason why these rookies like Jonathan Abram, like Furl, I think it's why they ultimately looked really good. And I'll tell you what, man, I am super, super excited to see what these rookies do during the regular season, because they looked really, really good in training camp. They looked good against the Rams. And during all the offseason reports, there's a lot of excitement. So I want to ask everyone who's watching the show, which rookie excites you the most? Which one just gets you going? Jonathan Abram, Cleveland Furl, Josh Jacobs, Trayvon Mullen. I'm trying to think. Max Crosby, Isaiah Johnson, Foster Moreau, Quentin Bell, some of the UDFAs, Alec Ingold. Like, which guy, which rookie excites you the most? I want you to comment below. And if you want to know who excites me the most, slide in those DMs at MitchellRenz365 on IG or on Twitter. Speaking of IG, I want to give a special shout out to some of these people who always interact with me on Instagram. And I encourage you guys to interact with me on IG as well. It's a good way for you to get to know me. And it's a way that we can continue to grow the nation. If there is one thing that always blows my mind, it's how much I love the nation and how much love that you guys give each other. So give a follow to all these people on IG. And also while you're at it, go give a follow to all these people on Twitter. Always sliding into my DMs. Always asking for my opinion. Just so you know, I appreciate you and I appreciate the nation. Let's continue to spread it. So I wanted to do this, something a little bit different here. I wanted to give out some grades, okay? Episode 1, I gave it a B grade. Like, it was a good show. Episode 2, I gave it an A grade. Now, you'll be able to find out what grades I give on August 20th, 27th, and 3rd while we wrap up Hard Knocks. But between you and me, my show is fun, it's interactive, but I want to know what you guys grade this show, okay? So episode 1, I gave a B. For episode 2, I gave it an A. So what would you grade episode 2 of Hard Knocks? A, B, C, D, or was it an F? If it's an F, you can go Tom yourself. So grade episode 2 of Hard Knocks, and make sure you guys are commenting below. I'll be looking down here in the comment section live. How many people we got live? Over 200? Rudy, my man, says that's an A. Matthew Pohl says A. Kalupa something says A. God, Julia says A. Crazy Raider is going with B. Guys, I appreciate everyone who's watching this live with me here on YouTube. And if you want to hang out with me when the Raiders play the Cardinals, put this in your calendar right now. Join me Thursday, August 15th at 8 p.m. Eastern time, okay? Raiders versus Cardinals watch party. I'm going to be cracking open a beer. We're going to be watching the game. We're going to be sitting down. We're going to be interacting with each other. We're going to be having a good old time. Raiders versus the Cardinals watch party. Join me. Okay, Thursday, August 15th at 8 p.m. Eastern time. Turn on those notifications on YouTube. Turn them on Facebook. We're going to be live. Raiders versus Cardinals. Get those early score predictions in. I'll see you guys Thursday, August 15th at 8 p.m. Eastern time.